Everybody, this is Adam Hirschberger. I am the VP of Sales and Marketing over at Mapletronics Computers, and joining me today is Wes Hirschberger, our CEO and founder. Thank you for joining us today, Wes.
Absolutely.
And we're here today to talk about our new line of managed cybersecurity products. We're calling it GUARD E.N. Security. We have a security maturity model to go alongside that, but the reason I brought you in, Wes, I want to ask you some questions about why security is so important today, why we're so hyper-focused on this, and maybe some of the origins of where this stuff came from.
Mm-hmm. So when I'm out talking to clients, one of the things that I hear constantly is the threat of cybersecurity is still a constant, something that's just always hanging over their minds, and just they're really worried about it, but don't know what to do about it. What's my next step? How do I get myself so I'm secure? They keep hearing about all these breaches that are happening and thinking, man, you know, if my business went down, the cost of that would just be astounding, not only in maybe the ransomware that goes, but in how much the productivity would be cut, and if I stop being able to see patients, or if I can't manufacture the widget, or whatever it might be. So there's just a growing concern, and as you know, the threat landscape is continuing to be pretty large.
Absolutely. I think the latest stat is inching towards that $400,000 range is the average cost of a breach these days. So an even more important topic to talk about, which is why, again, it's so top of mind for us. And you know, something we've started hearing a little bit more recently is even cyber insurance policies and the increase of, I guess, complexity that businesses are having to demonstrate in order to even get insured. I mean, can you talk a little bit more about what we're seeing there?
Mm-hmm. Sure. Let's just take ours for a little bit. I mean, we got a letter from the insurance company that said, if you do not have and meet these criteria, we won't insure you. We will drop you. And it was an extensive list. I mean, it's two-factor authentication on every system. It was a fairly extensive list. Talking to some of our peers across the nation, more and more companies are getting that kind of letter, both if you're in the IT business or if you're at any high risk, which today, I don't even know how you identify a high risk, because it's pretty much anyone who uses a computer system and you have a business that they can hold you for ransom.
End of the day, if you're going down, like you mentioned, your manufacturing line stops, your revenue stream stops in its tracks, and so whether or not you have any kind of valuable information or data in your network, and you're still a target, you can still be held ransom.
Mm-hmm.
Thanks for the overview there.
You know, insurance companies, the reason they're doing some of these things is because their risk has grown and their payouts have grown. I think this is going to be a continued thing. It's going to be an ongoing concern, and we're helping our clients try to get through that.
Absolutely. So kind of a couple factors there, growing risk, growing impetus to invest more in security from the business perspective of there. And so Mapletronics is kind of shifting what we do in order to meet the needs of our client base. So I want to talk a little bit about how we're going into that. But first, I want to talk about maybe where we've been with cybersecurity. And so just a quick summary, in the past, we've been more of that scattershot approach, and we've kind of changed our minds on that a little bit more. You talked about what we used to do and why we decided to change that.
Yeah, so we used to sit down with our clients and say, okay, here are the major areas that you should think about and the layers that you should put in place and the security that you should have in place in your organization. The problem that we had is trying to figure out what was the next step. So our clients trying to make those decisions on, okay, I know I'm here right now and I need to do these 7 things, or I need to do these 25 things. But which one do I need to do first, really, and which is going to make the most impact and help me along the way? So, and what we decided to move toward, and what you've already started to set up a little bit here, is that we went to a maturity model. And the maturity model says, if I am a company that really wants to be at level 4, let's say, on maturity, and right now I'm looking at this and saying, you know what, really, I'm at level 1. How do I get to level 2? And how do I get to level 3? And what are the little pieces that I need to do, or what are the pieces that I need to do to incrementally get there? Totally a different way of approaching it. Makes it so much easier for our clients to understand what next steps are.
So I am a client of Mapletronics, and again, I'm overwhelmed by cybersecurity. It's a big world. It's a lot of acronyms. There's a lot of confusing terms. And like you said, it's coming at me pretty fast right now. how do I use something like the maturity model to make some decisions for myself here?
So when we sit down with a maturity model, you can see this online, or you can also see it in sitting down with the CRM. But what happens is the first part of it describes the risks you're willing to take in the business and the impact that downtime and the security disruptions would be on your business. It describes that, and you can choose which area, which of those five levels that you feel you want to be at. With that translates to a list of services and standards that really need to be in place in order to be able to achieve that particular level of maturity.
What kinds of decision factors or criteria go into determining my level? And I'll throw it out there is maybe appetite for risk, right? How does a manufacturing facility and their appetite for business risk compared to, say, a hospital or a healthcare system and their appetite for risk?
So each one of those has a varying degree, right? So if I'm in a hospital, for instance, and I have information leak out about patients in some way, that's a big problem, because it's not only the fact that I've got to respond to that, but it's the cleanup costs, it's the costs that I have to make sure that patients are informed, insurances to help them to make sure that their identity is covered and not breached as well, and many other things that come along with that, as well as, you know, even in a hospital, if my major life-saving systems are go down, there is a real possibility I could put someone's life at risk, and that's a really big problem. Let's take a manufacturer on the other hand. Well, maybe nobody's life is at risk, depending on what you're manufacturing, right? My disruption costs, you know, if my production line goes down, if my disruption costs are, hey, it costs me $50,000 an hour to be down, or $100,000 or $2,000, whatever that number is, that disruption cost is something that you can calculate backwards and become pretty tangible with it.
Absolutely. So we know the security maturity model can fit pretty much any industry and fit, you know, size of organization as well. There's a lot of different components that go into it, but at the base level, you can really take a look at this model and get an understanding of maybe where you need to be as a business.
Absolutely.
So GUARD E.N Security is our new managed cybersecurity product. How does that correlate to the security model and this conversation that we're having so far?
So what we've done is we've packaged a bundles of services inside each one of the levels. So if you're at level one, it might have three or four different services built into it that are fully managed, along with certain standards that need to be met in order to reach that level. If you say, hey, I really need to be in level two, it takes all of those same ones in level one, packages and bundles them together in a level two package, all of them are together, as well as the standards and so on up the line.
Absolutely. And we can go into this, whether you're doing business with us currently or we're not?
We have, yeah. So what we decided on this one is security is really, really important. And for some of our clients that we manage their networks, it's easy to engage with us on the security side. There are many other clients out there and many other people that we have that we do some business with, or are future clients of ours, where they have their own IT department, but they just don't want to manage the security portion of it, or they don't have the bandwidth to manage the security portion of it. They can contract with us, we'll take care of the security portion of it, manage all that for them while they continue to manage their day-to-day operations on IT side.
I don't want to get too technical. Can you give us just a couple of buzzwords and maybe some services that we're offering within the different levels?
Sure. So once you get into like a level two, you have things like corporate controlled MFA and corporate controlled two-factor authentication. Let's say it that way. So the idea here is that, like in our system, every time that I go into major systems that have some issue, then I need to authenticate not only my username and password, but it sends me a push on my phone that makes me approve it on a second device. Mm-hmm. And the idea with that is if I'm a hacker and I've been able to get your credentials, like your username and password, then I still don't have your phone, so I can't get to the second part of it. So that's one of them. And the reason corporate control is when we looked at all of the different systems that we needed to protect, I think at one time the list was something like 50 some odd different applications and sites and things that we needed to protect. And once we got through that list, we realized how daunting of a task it would be if somebody left. You know, how do I go through and manage all of that? With a corporate controlled one, I can easily go in, remove that user, all of that two-factor shuts down. This is a nice way to manage it.
Just one short example of the 25 to 30 different services included within GUARD E.N security. You have other things like, you know, dark web scans, employee awareness training, and then all kinds of software monitoring and detection tools as well. So it really runs the gamut and is an all-inclusive cybersecurity suite there for you. So obviously we're very excited about this. This is a kind of a new venture for us that we think is a very large benefit to our client base.
Absolutely.
And couldn't be more ecstatic about releasing it this week here. As we're going forward here, obviously, if you have questions about security, we're going to flash up some phone numbers and some email addresses that you can reach out to for some more information. The security maturity model we've mentioned several times, download it. It's on our website. Go take a look at it. It really is we're calling it a self-guided assessment of where you're at maturity-wise as a business, and then gives you those standards and services that we feel pretty strongly correlate to that level of maturity. And finally, you can always reach out to me or any of the CRMs here at Peopletronics for some more information. But again, thank you for joining me today.
Okay.
Some great information, great conversation, and really looking forward to the value and the help we can provide to our client base moving forward. Thank you.
Thank you.